Hello Virgos, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the second half of October. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you, and they may be your energies of the person or the situation you're dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. And if the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign and your name sign, which is based on the first alphabet of your name. Now, like in all other readings, somehow in October the energies which I'm picking up are in contrast to each other, very happy and very sad or depressing sort of energies. Okay, so they are totally opposite. So please bear in mind, either if they are your energies, then maybe something drastic has happened in your life which has changed the situation totally, or if they are, maybe you're dealing with some person or the situation, and one of you is in a very good position and the other one is dealing with that depressive state or the upset state, whatever, the negative state. So please feel free to understand the situation as it is in your life. Okay, and for the personal reading, and the details are given in the description box below. So coming to the reading, Virgos, with the judgment card, something really great has happened, which a major event has happened in your life or is about to happen, whatever it is. It's something major has happened in your life which you actually wanted it to happen. You were praying for it. You actually wanted it to happen. It was causing you a lot of anxiety. It was causing you a lot of depression. Some sort of judgment has been made by the divine, and your gifts have been granted. But because you were there with the Three of Swords and with the Five of Pentacles, you were feeling bitter about some situation, or maybe you are still feeling bitter with whatever judgment has been made. You are not liking it. Maybe it can be for some of you that you are not very happy with the decision, though you longed for it. Maybe it is too late that you are getting what you wanted. It can be that, or it can be because you are not still able to, in spite of the decision being made in your favor, still you are not able to overcome this energy of Three of Swords, which is a very painful and a energy as if you've been stabbed. You feel very cheated, stabbed. People have really broken your heart and something like that. Because with the Five of Pentacles here also, you are leaving left out in the cold. Maybe it is a crash down of your finances. Okay, maybe because of that you were in such a bitter energy and very painful, or you were not very happy, obviously. So with the pain, Five of Pentacles, people are not with you, they're not helping you, feel you've been cheated, you've been left out in the cold. So this is one sort of an energy. Now again, the another one is the Two of Cups, which is again, it can be about the it is lovers or it is equal partnership. So even if it is a lover's energy or a partnership, there is has to be a mutual respect and mutual give and take in that situation. And it is followed by the World card and the King of Swords. So some things are changing. Things are really changing over here. And it is the end of one chapter, and it's the beginning of a new chapter, and you have got the clarity as to how to achieve your goals, your dreams, or whatever you want to achieve with the King of Swords. But over here, the guidance is, don't be cunning and do not be very manipulative in trying to achieve whatever you want to achieve. Only that is the only guidance. But yes, things are changing. Maybe after this situation, you get a new partner or you get a new relationship, maybe on which you can rely on which you can trust, and things will be better. And you will understand as to how you are supposed to move forward. Okay, because over here also with the Six of Lover Hearts, this is also the Lover's card over here. But again, it is about love and it is about beauty and union. So now this union can be, you see, it can be something like this also. Like me, you were in a very bitter situation, you were very unhappy, left out in the cold. Maybe it is a union of someone in your past who is helping you to come out of this situation, because it is about union also. So it can be a reunion, or you are united with your lover whom you wanted to be united with your friend or with your partnership, whatever. It can be different with different people. But yes, again, this energy is there that if it is a one person, then some judgment has been made which is helping you to come out of a negative state of affairs to a positive life. Okay, that is one thing which is definitely there. Okay, so obviously things are getting better, you are getting something, partnership or love or commitment, whatever it is, and you know you will be understanding how to move forward with clarity, and you will be in authoritative position, because with the World card, things are beginning, or the new chapter of your life is beginning. Now with the Messenger of Thought, a new topic or intellectual project is really exciting for you. There is so much to learn before you feel ready to move forward. New information may require changes in your plans. Review all your documents carefully. You know, or you will meet or you are someone who loves to learn and share knowledge. This person is a brilliant and a truthful, but also blunt and not very diplomatic. So that's what I'm saying. Maybe because this card is about partnerships also. This card is about reunions also. So maybe you will be meeting someone who will help you to, who has the knowledge of how to come out of this situation. If it is a professional situation, it can be that. Okay, and you are getting a project. Now this partnership can be a project also. It can be a new topic or a project, so that you will understand that with the help of this project, you will be able to, this will be the turning point of your life, and you will be able to come to this again emperor-like or a king-like energy. So what I'm trying to say is, you are definitely coming, it is a positive reading, you are definitely coming out of a negative situation to a positive situation, if it is the scenario or the cards are fitting to one person. Okay, so definitely some major decision has been made by the universe. You have not done much in it. You were just waiting for something good to happen. Now, number 31 or number 4 may be of some significance for you. Love makes a difference. Love helps to heal past hurts and provides a sense of security and self-worth. So basically, you should know that if you have trust in the situation, you have love and faith in the situation, you can sail through these turbulent waters. Just look at this female, this maiden, this beautiful angel. She is a mermaid. She is clinging to this loudspeaker, and she has all the dreams of a lover and all nice images and dreams she had, though her ship is sailing in turbulent waters. She really doesn't know, everything is in a turmoil, but she has the faith, and the butterflies in front of the loudspeaker, she is calling out to the universe whatever her dreams are. She has that faith, she has that confidence. So that is what, if you have that love, if it is see, partnership, union is here. Love makes a difference. What it is trying to say, if you have love, you have the trust on this relationship, this partner, this companionship, this partnership, if it is professional, whatever, if you are able to trust the situation, then you will be able to come out of it. Okay, because it is only love which can help you to heal the past effects. Nothing else can help you to come out of this negative situation. Now, if it is a personal situation which is not, even if it is not in accordance with the tarot reading here, it is a personal insight card. Maybe you are in such a situation, you are in a turmoil, or either you are not able to make solid foundations, you are not able to make solid long-term relationships. You should understand that if you are in a negative state of mind, you will attract similar people in your mind, in your life, and you, or either you will, if you get a nice person also, because you have hurt in the past, it is said that if you don't heal, you will bleed on people who have not even cut you. Okay, so you have to understand that you have to heal your past, and once you heal yourself, you will have that sense of security, you will have that sense of worth, and only then you will be able to come out of it and make a solid difference in your life, thereby attracting positive people to your life. Okay, so Virgos, what I understand over here is, overall the energies are, you are definitely, your situation is getting better. Situation is definitely getting better, and you are really, October is a very powerful month. You can, if you want, you can just see the theme of the month also. Similar energies were there. It is a very powerful month. Things, major changes are happening, and justice is being done this month. Okay, Virgo, so that's all I have for you. Please like and subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.